election. Yes, analysis. Yes, this is it.
And who can we say goes out and registers only Democrats? Raise your hand. You're looking at me. We're the ones who can go out and say we're registering Democrats. Is the Democratic Party? Yeah. But what it means is that we will have to develop our own voter registration drives, and we have a cube technique in Coconino County. If you have never thought of this, is we always take a picture of Robert Kennedy, John Kennedy, or Bill Clinton with us, and we put that picture on the front of the registration table. And so when people approach us, they know damn well who we are.
Is anyone looking at and trying to figure out how do we stop this tide of Democrats, probably some Republicans, not anybody, Democrats becoming independents?
The answer to your question, yes. Luis and other people have looked at this in great detail, and there's a lot of discussion you can do on that.
What are the solutions?
Well, I think the solutions are, attention to registration and all of
them. We're talking about kind of a postmortem, and one thing I want to remind everybody about is we no longer have a supermajority in the House, we no longer have a supermajority in the state Senate, and the tide's changing. I think a lot of people across this country have been turning away from the Tea Party extremism. Now, Arizona, as we all know, is way behind the curve. Okay? But we have an opportunity, I think. This election shows us an opportunity for how we need to do things in 2 years and in 4 years. And I think Arizona will come around. One of the things, though, I want to stress is we need good candidates, and we need to promote candidates at the local level.
Yes.
What is our product? We need to define the product that we're selling.
Well, my aunt's heel last night was what we've been selling is what they're doing wrong, basically.
But that's not working.
No, I hear you. One thing we might think about is at every level of this party, in every meeting, that we have a new mandated meeting agenda item. That is addressing the question of new registrations. In every meeting, at every level of the party, let this become a part of the thing, somewhat like the Pledge of Allegiance, maybe, huh? But until we get the registration up, how did the Republicans turn out their base this year? They did it with outside money.
Yes.
You can see that with Richard Mulder. They did it with Ann Kirkpatrick almost. They came very close to doing it with Ron Harper. And they're going to do it again and again and again. So our best hope is more registration. No way around. And there's just so many, ways to slice and dice this topic. Bottom line is we need more registrants.
I hear every 2 years that we ought to concentrate on new registrations, and every 2 years we get beat. Maybe it's time to think outside the box and think in terms of maybe it's the issues we ought to show to the Republicans that were kids rather than new registrations.
Well,
did
you go back to Jack?
Because if you look at who raised the most money, guy in Tucson, I think, Ted Vogt, at least in southern Arizona, raised almost $100,000, $99,900 and some. And he's an incumbent, of course, running in a new district. He lost. So show me the evidence where the money
their argument
is making
that
a difference.
Is the kick-up doesn't
can't pick it up anymore. If the Republican raises more money, you used to be able to get more.
And I would understand that, Dan, if they showed me someplace where it worked.
Right.
You know? Where did it work?
That's fair.
Yeah, but it's specious because there's no evidence for the goddamn thing.
So. It's always getting us on tape.
I'm gonna blackmail us. I'm gonna see this on YouTube.